Ladies and gentlemen, the children of all ages, producer Kenneth Feld proudly presents the 125th edition of Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus, the greatest show on Earth. Tomorrow we'll be touching stars in the skies. Today we have stars in our eyes. Wherever we go, wherever we are, we will have stars. We'll always have stars in our eyes. The universe is a mystery to explore. Open up your mind and let imagination soar. A wonderland lies just beyond your hand. Ask your heart and you will understand. Tomorrow we'll be touching stars in the skies. Today we have stars in our eyes. Wherever we go, whoever we are, we will have stars. We'll always have stars in our eyes. Beautiful, brilliant stars. Each and every one of us is so unique and glorious and divine. Tomorrow we'll be touching stars in the skies. Today we have stars in our eyes. Wherever we go, whoever we are, we will have stars.
An elephant in the beginning of the show in the parade around the rings and everything. Ronnie's a nice elephant. It's like a pet to me. My grandfather, Gunther Gable Williams, and my uncle, Mark, has been teaching me how to take care of the animals. Elephants eat a lot every day. They eat apples, carrots, bread, sweet feed.
You're right.
Yeah, that's right. That's me.
We have breakfast like an ordinary family. Then we go to school. And then we go to work together. And then we go do the show.
This year, we have three rings of beautiful animals. I work with five camels, Arabians, and Lipizzan. My sister performs with eight Liberty horses. And Christina works with five Belgian horses and four ponies.
People take for granted that the camels are, they don't look so intelligent, but they actually they are. They're very, very smart animals. Performing for the camels, it's like playtime. They hop around. They take some of it seriously. Some of it, they do pay attention, and sometimes they do it leisure.
This is my nephew, Lorenzo, and I'm very proud of him because he does almost the exact same things as I was doing when I was his age.
For 2 years, I've been working with the ponies in the ring. The Belgians stand on a platform and the ponies go under them. When they're done doing their tricks, I feed them carrots, and then they know they did something really good.
The horses are a very wonderful animal to work with. The beauty, the grace, and the strength of this animal is unbelievable. The hind leg walks, the jumps, the stands, it's just very easy for them to do.
Loves are asking me to stay. Both
that can take my breath away. Don't know what to do but break my heart in two. Until love can decide where it should go, which way will the wind blow? Which way will the wind blow? Which way will it blow?
Here we are, the circus kid. Very lucky group of kids. They have a wonderful life. They have the opportunity to travel all around the world, to meet so many different people, to play in different games, learn from each other, from different cultures. The Chinese, of course, have a different game than the Chicago kids have, but they all play together. And they learn what really counts is the person, not color of their skin, which language they speak. The most important thing is to make friends.
I'm from Bulgaria, right here.
I'm from Mongolia.
Washington, D.C.
Sarasota, Florida.
From Italy.
My name is Shirley.
I think Shirley, like every other kid in the circus, is very lucky to spend so much time with her parents and with her grandfather and grandmother. She's always with somebody of the family. I think that's very, very, very important for the kids.
My daddy is David the Clown, the most famous clown. And he makes me always laugh and stuff.
Bringing people with me in a ring, it's like bring everybody with me, because we play in an enormous arena, sometimes for 20,000 people. I decided to do a totally different act. One, it's more orientated to the kids, but everybody can enjoy it, and it's juggling with plates. I have to come out with some new acts, because the people that see me the year before, they don't want to see me do it the same act, even if they enjoy it. So you have always to come out with something new. Bringing the audience with me and try to juggling with this play bring always a moment of you don't know what's gonna happen. You don't know how this guy gonna throw the plate. You don't know how many plates he's gonna break. You know what I mean? So it's always something new, something fresh, every single show. And of course we break a lot of plates.
And now,
presenting
the
Chicago
Kids
in
the
greatest
show on earth.
Moving our feet to a brand new beat.
Driving beat.
A little bit funky and a little bit sweet. Dance all night, feel so right.
Feel so right.
Turn and burn.
Turn
and burn till the morning light.
We taught ourselves how to tumble on the streets of Chicago. There's 10 of us in the group, ranging from ages 12 through 17. It's like actually receiving a gold medal for what we're doing, you know. We kind of like put smiles on kids' faces, and people like to see us.
We're gonna dance all night, girl. We're gonna sweat our cares away. We're gonna let the music play. Yourself on a different beat. You better open your eyes, get out of your seat. You're gonna be amazed, you're gonna flip your lids. Nobody can fly like Chicago kids.
Chicago kids.
Do that. The rhythm of the city, grooving in the jungle. Living in the rhythm of the great city. Grooving in the urban jungle. Grooving, 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 grooving. Move that. The rhythm of the city, grooving in the jungle. Jungle.
shows whenever we have time. We'll play basketball, and usually all the Chicago kids would come. Whoever passes by and we ask them if they want to play, we'll just make teams, and we'll just start playing like that.
Hey, you think I can play basketball? Watch this.
I do an act called the Globe of Death. It's a huge metal globe, and three motorcycles ride around inside. I am one of them. A year and a half ago, I couldn't even ride a motorcycle. Then I started practicing little by little. I started going higher and higher until I can do what I do right now. I think the globe is a really interesting act because it's very dangerous and it's very thrilling and exciting, and it takes a lot of concentration to do an act like that. My favorite part during the globe is when my sister Desi comes in. She stands in the middle and we all take off and ride around. At one point, all the lights go off and we're riding around inside, only our costumes and our motorcycles glowing in the dark. Being a kid in the greatest show on earth is really nice because we get to travel around America and just see the whole country. It's a great feeling when the people look at you and they smile and they applaud at you because then you know you did a good job.
My brother Ivan and I, we also do the Wheel of Death, which consists of this big giant piece of metal that rotates in the air, and we try to keep a balance as we go around inside the wheels and outside the wheels also. It's also quite dangerous, just as dangerous as the globe too.
People ask us often why we do this type of acts, and we realize that besides being born into the circus in talent and performing, we are also, I believe, thrill seekers. We like to show the audience the enjoyment we also get from doing this type of acts.
Taron Taylor, he does a tiger act. I think it's really exciting what my dad does because not many people can do what he does.
I know every time he goes in there, he's risking his life.
It is that law of the jungle. You have to be the top cat and the boss inside there.
I think I've learned a lot about animals being around my dad. I've learned that you have to treat all animals with respect and to love all animals and treat them like their family.
Working with these animals here teaches everyone that you have to be responsible, we have a job to do. They're our big pets, they're part of our family. My animals get most of the attention even when my kids are around because I have to look after them first. Sit. And the kids understand this.
Axel, manas, manas, sit. Beat the mouse, Axel, sit. Ah.
From the United States of America, Tyrone Taylor!
I like the circus a lot, and I want to be with it for a very long time. Maybe when I get older, I can do acrobats or something.
I think the Chinese acrobats are amazing. I can't believe that kids that are younger than me can do things like that.
Flying pages, and our act consists of 10 people flying side by side, synchronized. It's very difficult to get the two catchers going up and down and everybody in line.
Ladies and gentlemen, the legendary triple somersault performed by Felix Pages.
I have my brother-in-law next to me that has a real secure triple because he always catches and I'm next with this announcement and it brings a little bit more pressure.
And now, one of the only women in the world today ever to accomplish the perilous triple somersault, Jill Pages!
After the triple, we do our version of passing leap. We have 6 flyers in the air, 6 people at one time working side by side, and everybody's going in different directions. It gives it a different effect.
Our moms are bungee jumpers and the greatest show on earth.
It's not only fun to be a clown, it's something I love, because I consider clowning a form of art. You have to spend hours and hours to find the right makeup, the right costume, something that is you, because you have to reflect your real personality. I love classic music, I love opera. So I decide to do an act that's involved the opera. What I do it is bring 3 people in a ring where the audience play the tenore, the baritone, and the soprano in a small intimate act.
Elephant and zebra act is very special to me because they are natural enemies in the wild. To get those to work together took a long time, and something that I guess I kind of take for granted now because they work so freely together. When I perform, I have this great feeling inside because I know that my father is there watching me, helping me, that he's just there for me, and that's very special. When I work my elephant act, I have 18 elephants on the arena floor. I'm out there in the center ring, and they're all working. They're doing what they really want to do. They're not told to do it. They do it because they do it willingly. And that's really what we try to achieve, is to let them do their own thing. This year, we found something new, where a young male Asian elephant throws Christina high in the air.
elephants. That's like my favorite animal.
I like watching Mark and his father perform with the elephants. I'd like to do it someday.
Not very many kids get an opportunity to do something like this where you travel all over the world and see different things.
And I like it too because I love meeting other people and stuff.
And because we're one happy family.